going to sing here in just a second. Just a couple of quick things. When we do the handshaking time today, we've recently had several people baptized. And so we're going to have them come up and stand right along here. I need to ask you something in a second because what I, the 199 is not what. No, okay. And we're going to have Miss Eileen come stand on this side, and we're going to give everybody the right hand of Christian Fellowship. This is kind of welcome to the family, and this is kind of a very sad, oh, enjoy Alabama, but we're going to miss you, okay? So she'll be back, her and Phil will be back close to their son, Sean, who is in Alabama, and she's been here. How long have you been here?
5 years, 10 months. Well, I started here 2 months after I got here, so...
But you've been, how long you've been, so you've been 5 years in Germany, almost 6.
Yeah, and in the church, I think 5 years, 8 months.
Amen. That's good. So, it's a very sad time to see her go. This is kind of a part of the military ministry, amen. But we're going to say, we're going to have a little fellowship afterwards so that you can say more. We've got a little plaque we're going to give her, but... Two other prayer requests, and then we'll get started. I'm sorry, it's like 7 after. I was shaking hands, seeing new faces. BJ, a little quick announcement. You two are my offering crew today. All right, so second, two prayer requests. Israel, okay? Now, as I was telling them in Sunday school, I understand the anxiety that people go through. But for those of us as believers, I think this is kind of like game day down south. Everybody's excited on game day down south. Why? It's just going to be a game, right? I don't know when it will come back. But these kind of things that's going on today, that's the kind of stuff you go, is it today? Is it today? Right? What does Job say every time he leaves? Y'all may not understand Job. Sometimes it's a little difficult to hear him when he's talking, but he says goodbye, Maranatha, which means, may the Lord come today. All right? So rather than being fearful about what's going on, hey, let's pray for them. The Bible says, blessed. And the Lord says he would bless them that bless Israel and curse them that curse Israel. Let's bless Israel. Let's pray for Israel. But let's look for the Lord. Amen? Number two. Adam was supposed to be here today. Adam is a young Air Force man. He is... I was called away to do some kind of emergency. He's an aircraft mechanic in another country, and his wife is home with morning sickness. She's having a real tough time with that. The ladies probably understand that much more than me, but let's pray for her. And then one more, Logan is TDY in Berlin. Actually has something to do with World War II, if I understand it. But anyway, let's pray for these families that are separated. And let's open in a word of prayer, and then we'll stand and sing. Dear Heavenly Father, we do thank you for all them that have gathered out here today, Lord. We do pray for Adam and Logan as they're away, TDY and Corey and Leon and Darla and Shane as they're away on various trips, Lord. We do pray for Angelina as she's home ill with one baby and sick in preparation for another. We pray that you would just touch and heal her body, Lord. Help her through this time, Lord, birth and pregnancy and so forth. It's just an amazing thing of procreation, and we love you for allowing us to be a part of that, Lord. And we just pray that you would strengthen her in this time, Lord. And I know she's missing the help that she gets from Adam, just like I'm sure McKaylee is missing the help she gets from Logan, Lord. We pray that you have your will there. We do pray for this situation in Israel. We put it in your hands, Lord. We ask you to protect your people there. We ask you to give our country the good sense to do what's right. And we thank you for all the people that have either been saved or followed the Lord in believers' baptism recently, and how we're going to see that again today, Lord. And again, we thank you for Eileen and the blessing she's been to this church, Lord. And we pray that today would just be a sweet memory as we try to say, God be with you, and she goes back to Gunnersville. Lord, we love you. We pray all these things, Lord. We thank you for the visitors, Lord. We've got Ralph, Chloe, and Jeremiah there, and Miss Flora, who I just saw at Penny's and invited. Lord, we love you, and we thank you for all these people that have gathered around today, and we pray that everything said or done glorifies that name above every name, Jesus Christ, our Lord. For it is in his name we do ask. Amen. Stand and turn to number 99, a shelter in the time of storm, in the big hymnal. Sometimes there are two hymnals, you're going to use the big one. 99. Savior leads me. We'll sing the first and the third.
Faith.
can't be your body. You need to be made alive the first time. You have to understand that God loves you. But just like me, you're a sinner. Sin has a salary that you and I can never pay. If we die apart from Christ, we spend eternity in a place of torment separated from God. And that's terrible news. Let's get back to the good news. God commends his love towards us. Mark, I've had a lot of people tell me they love me. But Jesus is the only one who laid down on the cross and said, I love you this much. And he got up 3 days later to prove he was God in the flesh. You see, God commended his love towards us. He demonstrated his love towards us. And while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. But friends, you can know all of that and still not be born again. There has to come a time when you call on Christ and ask him to forgive your sin. And be the Lord of your life. That's one thing. That's evangelism. Revival. That's you and I who already know that our name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Deciding that we're going to be as close to Christ as we can. And drawing near to him. And asking him to show us our sin. And forgive us our sin. And clean us up. So that we can be. I'm so tired of hearing people say so-and-so-so are heavenly minded. They're no earthly good. It couldn't be. You couldn't get any more heavenly minded than the Lord Jesus Christ, and he paid for your salvation. What we need to try, Jesus, is to be as close to God as is possible in this life and still be effective in the community. But it starts with all of us as Heritage Baptist Church coming together. Don't answer out loud. But do you really want to be revived? Or are you like the Pharaoh talking about salvation? Anybody remember what the Pharaoh said? Tomorrow. 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 I heard a sermon once to marriage. One more night with the frogs. She was tired of those frogs, but tomorrow. Christian, let's not wait till tomorrow to seek his face. False person, don't wait till tomorrow to get saved. Dear Heavenly Father, I do thank you for all that have gathered out here today. I know it's after 12. I pray that you've spoken to hearts, Lord. Lord, I thank you that we were able to see that true revival there where God's people came back together after walking in defeat to draw close to you and be used of you to reach multiplied thousands. Lord, I thank you that the scripture says a few chapters after what we read today, these that have turned the world upside down have come hither also. Lord, I know that you can use Heritage Baptist Church in such a fashion. I pray that you would help us to be dissatisfied with a cold, one foot in the world, one foot in the church kind of life, and draw close to you, and thereby closer to one another, so that you'll hear our prayers, forgive our sin, and heal our land. And Lord, I know it's possible that in this room there are those who do not know you. I pray, if that's true today, that today would be the day of their salvation. As we stand now and prepare for an invitation and for baptism, we ask you again to work in our church your way, which in Christ's name we ask it all. Amen. You may stand. The altar is open. I'm going to ask Brother Mike to go ahead back here and get ready for baptism. I'm going to stand here just a moment. stand here this morning, and as I see people coming to the altar, I think of the story of the prodigal son, where he decided to go home and ask his father if he could be a servant. But his father was looking down the road and ran to him. Christian, that's how the Lord is today. He's looking for you. He wants to have that closeness you once had with him. Will you come today? Brother Derek, if you'll come forward after the baptism, I'll have you pray over the meal.
Y'all could hear me getting all this preacher in these little
bit. Any waiters, amen. Brother Mike has recently faced some trials. He came to us some months ago, and he has been very faithful to church. But in the midst of some trials recently, he realized that he had never come to know Christ as his Lord and Savior, even though he was in church. And so he was in here one Sunday night exact words, but it was something to the effect of, I'm one up on you. Took care of that last night. I asked the Lord to save me. So I asked him some probing questions and I agreed with him that he had come to know the Lord as the Savior. And so I'm going to baptize him today on his public profession of faith. You're trusting in Christ alone for your salvation, right? All right. Now, I need to tell you this before we baptize. He really wanted to go home and be baptized where his wife and kids should be present. But Brittany, his wife, encouraged him. You know, it's a local church ordinance. You need to take care of it at the church where you are. So Mike prayed about that. He decided it was more important for his kids to see him obedient to the Lord than to be present for his baptism. So on his public profession of faith and obedience to the Lord Jesus Christ, I baptize you, my brother, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, buried in the likeness of his death, raised in the likeness of his resurrection to walk in newness of life.
Amen.
Us, Lord, as we go and enjoy this meal that we have, Miss Arlene, we pray for that we be with her and just watch over her and her husband and keep them safe. We pray for the food, we pray for the hands that make the food, we just pray that we nourish our body. We just give you all the praise and glory and all the thanks. Pray for the rest of the day, pray for the fellowship, we just pray that all that we do, we bring honor and glory to you.